Last week on Amplified, you saw the fiberglass box for the SRT8. We made the front panel. And we also started two iPad dashes, one for a Camaro and one for a Porsche. This week, we're gonna attach the two pieces of the box and make it all one piece and reinforce it and make it solid. We're also gonna get these iPad dash panels done while Wishbone spies on us like a creeper.
This episode of Amplified is brought to you by Audible.
So now we're gonna attach the box into one piece with fiberglass, and we're gonna measure our airspace so we know how big our port needs to be.
Now it's time to paint the Camaro panel. Wishbone doesn't have the prettiest face or anything, so he's not allowed to be on the show. So he's always trying to sneak into the camera frame when we're painting or just trying to do something productive.
So you call it Sierra Misty. He keeps looking at the camera and keeps peeking at it. That's what you call a toolbox.
I got it! With a weird shaped box like this, it's hard to find the airspace. We need to know how much volume is inside this box. So what I like to do is take these air pack, air bubbles, you stuff them in the box, fill up the box, then you can take them out and put them in a cardboard box and measure it out and see how much volume of air you have in there. Then we're gonna input that into the software and see how big our port needs to be. Wishbone always thinks we're talking about him. And he keeps peeking like, oh, I know they're talking about me. In this case, we are talking about him. But in some cases, we're not talking about him and he thinks we are.
You guys talking crap still? Because I look over into the room, which has a window, and I see you and Rafa, and I can read lips for the most part. I mean, it's hard to read Rafa because he speaks Spanglish most of the time. But I kept seeing Wishbone being said, and I can kind of hear you. So are you done talking crap now, or?
No, you can't hear from in there. Go in there and say something. I want to see. You can't hear a thing, bro. One of the most important things you got to do when you hook up an amp or processor is check your head unit. We need to find the maximum undistorted output of the head unit. You can do this with a SMD DD1, or you can do it with an oscilloscope. The Audison BitTune has a built-in oscilloscope. Right now you're seeing the sound wave, and you can see the distortion when you turn the head unit up. It looks like the sound wave just getting chopped off at the top. The SMD DD1 does the same thing. When the distortion light comes on, that means your signal is clipping. And clipping signal is bad.
Is he looking at me? Is he looking at the camera?
Oh yeah, you can go past that.
Bro, Rafa thinks I'm a creeper now, he should see me when I'm outside his mom's house.
Put some sound deadening material behind the box so we can test bump this woofer.
These are not going to be utilized in this application, so we're going to return them to the factory location. There you go. There you go, sir. That's for you. And then down here,
we're using this little one, this little sucker.
So it weighs 3.2 ounces. It's very light. Very proud of the lightness. 3.2 ounces is really light. It doesn't fit anymore. Factory bolt hole. Now we got a in the top. Screw. And we're good.
My muscles feel big today, cause I'm strong.
If I was cheese, I would be shredded cheese. And Rafa would be Swiss cheese, cause everyone's f***ing his holes. That was kinda weird.
So we're in a Ford Focus I got to rental. We're going to Vic's Upholstery Supply to pick up some corpet. For my cousin's back panel, it has to match perfectly because the other side has carpet and we're trying to keep it factory carpet looking. Vic's is a Mexican upholstery supply house in Van Nuys, California. It's a secret place for all your upholstery needs. They got Alante vinyl, which is what you want. Boys and girls, look up Alante vinyl and buy it and wrap your boxes with it. It's really good.
They got carpet and they got suede for all you Mexicans that like to do your headliner.
They have, it's called Ultra Suede. Look it up, boys and girls, you need that too. Alante vinyl and Ultra Suede. We'll find all the fine materials as soon as we get there.
So now Doug got a wild hair up his ass, and we gotta put back speakers.
Is how you say valley in Mexican. Oh, we can't go in this way. This is not the correct way. We're gonna have to flip the
Tuck it tight into this corner.
See, this is the shit I can't do in my truck.
Yeah.
I'm gonna smash this trash can.
Yeah.
I'm gonna hit this gate.
Oh, bro. Hold on. Hold the horn.
No, I hit the gate. I hit the gate.
I'm all good. I don't need an ambulance.
Okay, now we're gonna back up and hit this truck.
Oh, shit.
We've been testing and tuning this thing the whole time it's been here throughout the whole install, and getting signal from this factory system is pretty difficult. We've run into a few hairy problems, as they call them. They call them hairy. They call them hairy problems because no one wants to deal with anything hairy. You know, you want everything clean shaven like my nipples. Man, I'm white. The signal from this factory system distorts really early, and it's also crossed over, so there's two different outputs we need to make work. So this is the signal of our 6x9. That's our other 6x9. And this is a 3-inch, so it's crossed over in the amp. There's an output that says this is for the 6x9, this is for the 3-inch, and then two tweeters come off the 3-inch that's in the door. So what we have to do is put those two together, And on top of it, the outputs don't even work unless they sense a speaker. So we have to use a 47 ohm 5 watt resistor so that the factory amp sees a load. That way we could steal the signal out of it and make it better.
Is this La Hambra?
No, this is La Hambro. Wishbone's a sucker.
A sucker!
Tune that, another way, shoot that. Just got a head dish, try to get a groove back. Touch it like an iPad, baby, I'm a true Mac. Don't even trip, I got other hoes too. Baby, I didn't even really want to fuck with you. Had one drink, now you get a little...
Next week, we're just gonna finish this thing up, put it all back together, and finish the tune. And then I'll finally be able to breathe again.
All right, got my truck back. Would you like an icebreaker? Didn't think so. It was broken. It was found on the road dead. I admit it. So they gave me a Ford as a rental and I crashed it. So now we're gonna break my truck again.
You crashed the rental.
Thank you for watching Amplified. This week's sponsor is Audible. Audible is where you go to listen to books with your head. So when you're busy doing other stuff like driving, cleaning, gardening, you may be doing yard work around your house, mowing the lawn perhaps. I don't know what you're doing, but what you could be doing is listening to a book while you're doing those things. Go to audiblepodcast.com/amplified and they're going to give you a free book just because you watch Amplified. All the audiobooks are playable on all your portable devices. You can play them anytime, anywhere, and since Audible's an Amazon company, it'll sync up with what you're reading on your Kindle. So you could read it, and then listen to it, and then go back and read the rest, and mix and match. You could mix and match your reading. Go to audiblepodcast.com/amplified and go check it out and get your free book. Get your book on. And go to caraudiofeed.com. Amplified is filmed on location at Soundman Enterprises Inc. in Valencia, California, Soundstations in Newhall, California, and Mies Car Audio in Lancaster, California.